Hi friends, this is Heidi Samuelson with Mrs. Samuelson's Swamp Frogs, and I wanted to bring to you a communication device that I use with my parents that will allow me to text them quick and short reminders about an upcoming event, and it's free as a resource to you, and it's also something that when you text them, they can receive it as a text, but they cannot respond back to you. So it's a safe and free communication device. If you go to Remind101.com and click on the Get Started button right here, it'll bring you to the front page where you're getting started. And I went ahead and I'm putting together a class for my son. So I've got it signed up. I've got all of his first name, the email that I want to have the reminder sent to, and a password that I can remember really easily. Once I click on Getting Started, and the next button will take me to what I want to call the class name. Now, if you're a teacher that has more than one class coming to you, for instance, period one, period two in the higher grades like middle school and high school, or if you are departmentalized and you maybe have a reading class one or reading class AM, reading class PM, math class AM, math class PM, you can go ahead and name your class however you would like to name it. Since this is my son's class, I'm going to go ahead and name it Horn Tutoring. And then you add that class in. And then once you add it in, it's going to give you your specific number that you're going to share with the people that you want to receive your texts. So what they're going to do is they're going to text at Horn, which you can see right here, at Horn T, and they're going to text it to this number. And that's going to subscribe them into your specific class texting session. So to remind myself of this, I'm going to go ahead and do Shift, Command, and 4 on an Apple, and that gives me my little screenshot machine. I don't know if you knew that or not. And so then I can click and hold this, and I can take a screenshot of this, so I can use that. It comes up as a PNG on my screen, and I can use that just like I use a picture to share the information. I'm going to click the next, and that's going to take me to the actual message area where I can send just a sample message, and I can skip this or I can go ahead and send a message and see what it looks like. So if I type in here and I just type a real quick testing the Horn Tutoring class and send it, it'll send it through, and then you'll come to your home page. When you log in to Remind101 from now on, you'll see up here is all of your information where you can go and check on your account. We can do widgets, which we'll talk about in another video about how to add the widget to your website or your blog so that your parents can go in and see a live version of the texting that's going on. Maybe they don't have a smartphone, but maybe they have a smart computer, and so they can see your texts on the computer. You can add another class here. Again, what I remember what I said about if you have more. So for instance, let's say he has another class, and that class is Mellophone Tutoring. And when I add that class, it'll come up and it'll be a whole nother class, and it has a whole nother at message. And so they can join this class. And so when you are then going through, you can choose, do I want to send somebody to the Horn, a message to the Horn Tutoring, or do I want to send a message to the Mellophone Tutoring? And so you can separate your messages out. You can, you know, copy and paste the same message and send it to the same people. Over here you can see your subscribers, and you can see who is already subscribed to your class and who gets information from your class. And down here you can see all of these messages that have already been sent. And you have, we'll talk about this in a later one too, you can also tweet the message, resend the message. And this is kind of a neat thing. For the Horn Tutoring, I might say, don't forget music this Thursday. And I can schedule that to be sent. instead of sending it now when they'll get the text message and they might forget it, I can schedule that to be sent on the 13th, and I can even tell them what time I want it to be sent at. Probably not a good idea to send it at 3 a.m. in the morning, although I have been known to do that. So if I send it for that, and then I can schedule it, and that'll be scheduled on my thing. It'll go out automatically. I don't have to worry about it again, and it shows me that this is scheduled to be going out on Tuesday. I can go back in and edit it, or I can get rid of it altogether if I decide I don't want to do that. Here you can see where you've got a print. The print option allows you to put together, it puts together a little PDF that you can send to your parents, and it'll give you the information on how to sign up for that, why it's safe, and how they can use it in their life to make it easier. So just a real quick way of getting together that Remind 101 so that your parents are getting quick test messages, and hope that was useful to you. Check back later. We're going to talk about how do we add the widget to your website so people can see what you are texting, even if they don't have a smartphone. Have a great day.